Consider the system AX equal to B, where A is n by n, and A is invertible. Clearly, this system has a unique solution given by A inverse times B. But sometimes it's more convenient to use what is given by the Cramer's rule. Cramer's rule says that for the unique solution X, Xi is equal to determinant of Bi divided by the determinant of A for I equals 1 up to n, where the matrix Bi is obtained from the matrix A by replacing column I with B. So suppose that A is the matrix 1, 2, 2, and 3, and B is the tuple 4, 5, then the unique solution is given by x1 equal to. So the matrix that appears on top will be obtained from A by replacing column 1 with B. So 4, 5 in the first column. The second column is the same as in A. And the determinant of A goes down here. And that gives me 2 divided by minus 1, so that's minus 2. And x2 is going to be given by the determinant of 1, 2, 4, 5 divided by the determinant of A, and that's minus 3 over minus 1, which gives me 3. Cramer's rule is not so much used in computations, but it is a very useful tool in obtaining certain results. For example, we can use this to obtain a formula for the inverse matrix. Let A be an invertible matrix, and let B be the inverse matrix. So B is a matrix such that A times B is the identity matrix. This can be rewritten as a system of n equations where Bj is the jth column of B and Ej is the jth column of the identity matrix. Now, by Cramer's rule, we can see that the ith component of Bj, which is of course Bi, j, is given by the determinant of Mi divided by the determinant of A, where Mi is obtained from A by replacing column I with Ej. Alright, so column I will have all zeros except in row j, which is a 1. We can actually simplify this determinant. Because everything is 0 except in the jth entry of column I, expanding the determinant along column I will give me this, minus 1 to the j plus I times A j vertical bar I. And that we can call it C j comma I. Now be careful of the indexing. Is j before the I, and it is for the entry b I comma j. And so b I comma j is given by C j comma I divided by the determinant of A. And since b is the inverse of A, that will tell me that the inverse of A is given by 1 over the determinant of A times this matrix of cofactors. So C1, 1, C2, 1, and so on up to Cn, 1 in the first row. And the second will be C1, 2, C2, 2, and Cn, 2, and so on all the way to C1, n, C2, n, and so on to Cn, n. And that is the formula for the inverse matrix of A.